lot of people use VFDs to reduce the size of a generator set, and you can do that too with a fire VFD. But there is a caveat you need to make sure you're aware of. There is the bypass mode, so you have to be sure the generator can start in the bypass mode. And the bypass mode are typically either across the line, primary reactor reduced voltage starting, or soft start starting. And so when you check your programs, there's one other thing that you need to look at as a VFD. There's an exception in NFPA 20, paragraph 9.4.3, that allows you to reduce the voltage when using the bypass mode of a variable speed controller. So we guarantee on our controllers that you can drop the voltage to 25%, which will allow you to size the generator differently than dropping the voltage only by 15% as a normal fire pump would allow. So by calculating the VFD, and the VFD by itself is just the cat's meow. It just works great on a generator set. There's no issues. But the bypass, you have to be careful with. And like I said, back to looking at paragraph 9.4.3 is the important part to be able to size, reduce the size of your genset with a VFD. And by looking at that paragraph, you also have to know that the manufacturer's control system and VFD can operate at that 25% lower voltage, which of course ours can't.